Hello. So Grazia Daily have tracked down British Olympic cyclist Victoria Pendleton to ask her some questions, very important ones. Obviously 2012 is coming up very soon. We wanted to ask Victoria about her hair care routine. Looking stunning today.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Have you done this yourself?
I wish I had, but no, I'm not as good at hairstyling. So no, someone's given me a little bit of help today.
I like it.
Thank you.
Slightly Kate Middleton inspired.
Oh, well, thank you.
Not quite as much height.
No,
though,
no.
Could
work on
could
that.
Could be a good thing. As a professional sports person, is it hard to find time to look after your hair, or does it work?
Well, definitely. I mean, it's, you know, when you're concentrating on your training, the last thing you want to be thinking about is really your hair and your makeup and everything like that. You want to look good, but you don't want it to be difficult. It's got to be easy. So it's important that you kind of use the right kind of products to make it as straightforward as possible. I mean, at the moment, obviously, a bit of Pantene here, sleek and smooth, keep it under control. But things like that are really helpful because they're reliable products. It's easy. It's just in your routine.
And when you're training, you're in the same place every day. Do you have your own shower, the VP shower?
No, area? Not quite. I've got my own locker. Does that count?
Yeah.
I've got a locker. That's it. So yeah, just tend to like get ready at the track, and obviously you want it to be really quick and easy. You don't want to be hanging around in changing rooms for too long. You just want to get out and get some tea. Usually, that's usually my priority.
And then
I know it's sad, isn't it?
Get some tea. Well, yeah. Our nation was built on tea.
Yeah.
We heard that after you finish in a bit, after you retire, your next plan is a big wedding.
Yes.
So how's that going? That's like the most girly thing.
Yeah, I mean, I have made a point of not doing any planning yet because I want something to look forward to. When I sort of finish cycling, and it's going to be a bit manic because he's Australian and we don't even know where to get married at the moment. So I haven't got very far in the planning. I'm just going to leave that till after the Olympics so I can focus on what I'm doing right now.
What's the country in the world that's halfway between Britain and Australia?
I don't know, somewhere.
Most of the world, actually.
Yeah, I don't know, somewhere. I mean, I did think, I don't know, on a beach somewhere would be nice, somewhere warm.
Would you like to go for a kind of simple beach?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind. I'd like something really simple, actually. But yeah, as I say, I'm leaving it all up to after the Olympics for planning. Something to look forward to and basically not to be a distraction at the moment. I don't know how Keri-anne's done it. She's managed to organise hers very quickly. But
is Keri-anne getting married as well?
Yes,
and
we all are.
Oh, that makes some of us feel like we've not really pulled our finger out and achieved it. I'm not being in the Olympics or getting married. What have I been doing all this time?
I don't know, maybe we're just lucky.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Victoria. So Grazia Daily are here with Keri-anne Payne, a British Olympic swimmer. We're going to be discussing a wide range of topics from beauty tips to the 2012 Olympics, which we're all excited about. Thank you for chatting to us. You're looking very glamorous today.
Thanks. It's always nice when somebody can, you know, spend 10 minutes or more than 10 minutes just sort of putting makeup on. It's really nice.
Have you had a mini makeover this morning?
A little bit, yeah.
And are you getting quite used to having your face and your hair done professionally?
There's been a couple more definitely since sort of in the last couple of years that people have, you know, done photo shoots and things. So, but it is such a nice thing to do because I literally spend most of my time with wet hair. Like I go to bed with wet hair, wake up with wet hair.
Really?
So not usually. If I leave it tied up, then it's wet. But yeah, so it's really nice to have it done and, you know, be all girly again for the day.
So what products do you like?
The Pro Expert toothpaste is literally amazing. I will talk to somebody about it all day. I learned all about it and how it was made, and you know, it took 15 years to make, and just using it, I've literally been using it for 3 weeks, and I've noticed the difference in 3 weeks so far using that. And the Triumph 5000 toothbrush, is the combination is fantastic, but I literally can't get over. I feel like I'm turning into like a toothpaste lady talking to everybody about toothpaste, but it's just so interesting. Yeah, it does make a big difference.
I presume you can't really wear makeup
We don't wear like a full face of makeup, but I mean, for me, it's always about, you know, just the little things. So a massive part of sort of my routine is, you know, just putting a lick of mascara on. So it's brilliant to have something like the Max Factor false lash effect, because it is so quick. It literally takes 5 minutes, but you look like you've put, you know, you spent half an hour putting false lashes on. It's amazing.
With the Olympics coming up next summer, you've been doing a lot more press and a lot more appearances. Have you been on TV and things like that?
Done a few little things. I think we were on, you know, there's normally like Sky Sports News and things like that. Nothing not that I really watch all that often.
Exciting though.
Yeah, really exciting. Definitely having, you know, talking down to a camera, or, you know, there's a journalist talking to you and you've got your sort of cameras everywhere. It's really, really nice to do something different. You know, we went on Daybreak as well. We were at a location, myself and Rebecca Addington were both doing something for Daybreak, which was really weird because we could hear them in our ears, but obviously we couldn't see them, so it was a surreal
experience. Nerve-wracking.
It was a bit nerve-wracking, yeah, because you wanted to make sure it was live, so you have to make sure you get everything spot on. It wasn't like you could stop it and then carry on. Yeah, so just to make sure you didn't say the wrong thing.
No, you don't. You aren't on the spot. Do you think you're getting a bit more confident in...
Yeah, I mean, I can talk about swimming all day. You can ask me any question about swimming and I'll literally sit here and bore you to death about it. So it's easy to talk about those kinds of things. For me, as an athlete, it's really nice to talk about what I love doing, and people are really interested in it as well, which for me is, you know, why I can carry on talking all day about it. So that's the side that I found really interesting,
you know.
And I really like that. And I do feel more confident about it because I know it so well.
So thank you very much indeed for all of that, Keri-anne, telling us your adventures. It was a pleasure to meet you. Good
you
luck
too.
In
thank
the
you very
Olympics.
Much. Thank you.
So the heptathlon is basically 7 events, they're all track and field events, and they're done over 2 days. So on the first day it's the 100 metre hurdles, the high jump, the shot put, the 200 metres, then come back on the second day and it's the long jump, the javelin and the 800 metres.
Do you have to, does it have an effect on your skin training so much? Do you have a lot of showers and can it get dry? Or?
Yeah, I mean you do shower a lot because you're training so much that it can get quite dry. Or
drier,
you know,
than the lazy bones like me, obviously.
Just a little bit drier, but it's also quite oily as well because, you know, you're sweating a lot. So it's nice to have a light moisturiser that, you know, really kind of keeps everything fresh.
We wanted to ask you some girly questions about your kind of beauty regime. Mm-hmm. Obviously, if you're constantly training, working out, do you have a lot of time to pamper yourself? And
Well, yeah, it's loads of training and there's not always, you know, you don't have those days where you can just completely pamper. But obviously I do love to, you know, I wear makeup when I compete. I obviously like to look after my skin and just have like a really simple, you know, cleansing, moisturising regime at home. So I'd always, you know, obviously wash, always use, you know, a good cleanser. So Olay's Essential Cleanser is great for just, you know, getting all the sweat and grime off your face after training. And a light moisturiser after, so it's nice to have something that's got, you know, SPSF in it and it's going to protect your skin, but it's light, it's not going to clog your skin up as well after training. So Olay's Essentials is really good for that and it works really well for me.
Thank you so much to
Thank you.
Jessica for chatting to us and putting up with our nosy questions, and obviously massive good luck.